Hi guys. What happened to my pretty camera? Should be working. Okay, it's working now. Some technical difficulties in the beginning. Yeah, what I was going to say is, hi guys, this is Prios. I'm a professional gambler and lately playing a lot of poker. And yeah, this is my study session after today's session, which was successful in terms of dollars won, but not successful in terms of BB 100 EV. But this doesn't matter if you make all your EV on PLO 1K and lose on PLO 100 and PLO 200 and PLO 500, although PLO 500 was not played that much, but I played for like 3 hours or something, one table on of PLO 1K. Yeah, let's look into this stuff. Although I'm not sure if these are the hands from today. Yeah, I think so. So let's see what we got today. So we 3-bet pre-flop and get a very bad flop. I guess our plan is to check behind, but let's make sure. Deuce 7-4. Or is this hand actually from yesterday? I think so. If I remember correctly, 7. We are supposed to do a lot of checking. Betting here can't be that bad. As the small blind will not hit this flop that often either. Okay, small little mistake. Small blind is checking. Now we need to download the sim and then should get our answer for the hand. Might be the case that this was a hand from yesterday, but it can't be too bad to check this out again. So actually, we are supposed to bet a ton still. Yeah, I guess fold to raises most of the time. Now we are supposed to bet 50% of the pot in 60% of the cases. Let's see what our hand should do. Let's just make it rainbow for simplicity's sake. And yeah, this hand is betting a lot more than it's checking. So betting was a play, and I guess folding against the raise. So let's see what happens if we get raised. What size we want to choose? Let's go full pot. Ace, king, jack, ace. Yeah, this has to be a fold once getting raised. Can't imagine that it is not. Yeah, it is. So next hand. So we are in a single raised pot with aces, no flush draw, but no open-ended straight draw. Three, seven, ten. Let's first reset the sim. Fold, raise from middle position. Oops, back. Call from the button. Everyone else folds. The board is 10-7-3. Ten, seven, three is not available. I think it might be the case that we had this problem already yesterday, but anyways, let's check this out again. Download ace ace 8-9 with, we got a backdoor draw, we also got a backdoor draw. In our case it's diamonds, as we had to choose a board that's a bit different from the one we actually had. And let's make the other suit hearts for simplicity's sake. And yeah, we are supposed to check always. Okay, and if we now are confronted with a bet, what is our plan? Okay, I think I misplayed or didn't put in the bet, so I guess it's a call. Yep, it's a call, and we would re-raise if we got spades too. Yeah, so I shouldn't have bet out, and yeah, I see the reason why we want to check. If we bet and get raised, we are in a really ugly spot and we definitely want to avoid it, and we also need to strengthen our checking range, and that's why we need to have some stronger hands in our checking range too that can continue against action from our opponents. And this hand can often call a turn bet too, and possibly even a river bet on the right cards. So yeah, I perfectly get it. And yeah, okay, let's move on to the next hand. This might be a very quick session today. Oh, that's actually an interesting one. Tja, what are we supposed to do with this hand preflop against a button open? I mean, actually, I think it can, oh, it's really hard to say. I can imagine that's a call, I can imagine that's the fold, I can imagine that you could even re-raise. So yeah, that's a very tough one. I think most likely, I say it's a fold, but yeah, it can go either way, I guess. Ace, king, queen, seven with many spades. Yeah, it's a fold. What if we subtract one of the spades? If it's having spades, we can either call or sometimes even re-raise, as you can see. Yeah, so that's a very close one. Very tiny changes to our hand make a fold what it was prior re-raise now. Oh, that one is, I guess, not that tough as it might seem. This is a 4-bet pot, but I think we need to check and fold. Although this feels very dirty if you got aces and almost put all your money in preflop. But let's see what the solver thinks about this problem. 9-8-7 with a flush draw possible, and it's on us. and we got ace, ace, deuce three. And yeah, we are supposed to check any of these, as you can see. And let's now see how we should react in case we face an all in. I guess calling when having the flush draw and folding otherwise. Yep, that's exactly what I thought. Yeah, even the three high flush draw would be enough. Yeah, just wanted to make sure, but yeah, this was kind of obvious to me that I had to check fold on a board like this. What happens? Let's make it a bit tougher. Let's change the board to something not that bad for aces and see how this changes our decision. What isn't that bad for aces but still very annoying? What about the same thing with no flush draw possible? Ace, ace, deuce three. Again, 100% check. And I guess still check. Oops. Yep, sorry. Here's all in. We download. And ace, ace, deuce three. I think it's still folding, and it is. Pick, and let's try one more board. This one is already a bit better, but I would imagine it's still a check fold. Ace is 2-3, it's always getting checked. And if we face an all in, ace is 2-3. Oh, now our range already becomes a lot wider. Oh, actually, it doesn't, so I just misread the situation. We are again just being able to continue if we got the flush draw, otherwise we can't. I said this would be the last board, but let's do one more. Let's do something that I found kind of interesting. Jack 7-5. Okay, that's the one. Download. Ace ace 10-3. And yeah, okay, this is already good enough to stick it in always. So yeah, and keep in mind this is a board where a straight is not possible yet. Maybe we can find a board where a straight is possible, but we are still allowed to get it in. So I lied again. This wasn't the last board, but this hopefully will be the last one. Yeah, 8-7-6. That seems too bad. 7. Not a very beautiful board with a 7. But do we got something with an 8 that looks quite bad? 8-7-5. Download. Ace, ace, deuce 3. I wouldn't expect him to have hit this that hard. And you can see We are all in, basically, with our entire range on ace, on 8-7-5, although a straight is already possible, and even with no flush draw, we are able to play this for stacks, as we expect our opponent to not have hit the 8-7-5 as hard as the 7-8-9. So yeah, this is should I keep going? Got a message. Hi, nice stream and YouTube channel. Keep going forward with this and grow your channel. Glad to see another PLO stream around. Yeah, thanks for the feedback. And yeah, I'm happy that you like it. Yeah, tell your friends. I don't like the fact that I have that little viewership yet, although I lately posted pretty much daily. But yeah, it's growing steadily but slowly. I would like to pick up the pace a bit, but yeah, what can I do? I mean, I would go through these hands anyways, so it's not like I produced this extra. So yeah, I guess it's okay to still do that. But yeah, if I'm not picking up success soon, I might be ending this and just doing it for myself, because it's again a bit faster than doing it on stream. And yeah, let's move on to the next hand. I found this one was a very not very, but a tough one. I'm not sure. The first thing I'm not sure about, if I'm supposed to 3-bet, and if I'm getting 4-bet, if I can call or get it in. So let's try to find out. If this is a blind battle, it's getting raised, re-raise, and another raise. And yeah, let's see if our hand is in there. Ace, nine, queen, queen. Apply filters. Okay, the ace, nine, queen, queen is in there. And it seems that if we had the double suited version of the hand, we are supposed to get it in. But with the single suited version, the fold is still correct. And that's what I did. And yeah, I think you should not only look into the GTO solutions. You also need to look into the stats of your opponents, because I recognize some of the regulars are very spewy with their 4-bets. They put in stuff that's a lot looser than the GTO ranges. For example, something like 7-8-9 jack with just one suit. And yeah, against these guys you definitely shouldn't fold. But I also looked in the detailed stats from this guy in session, and I also got a bigger sample size on him, and I think his 3-bet was just like 3-point-something%. And yeah, I figured that it's not worth it to try getting it in with this hand against this type of player, who will have aces the majority of the time, against which I'm crushed. That's a 3-bet. Is this a 3-bet pot? I think so. But the action is a bit strange. I think this might have been something weird. I think it was, because I think someone was open raising for like minimum or something, and I decided to 3-bet. That's a bit loose, I know, but yeah, I still did it. Yeah, and afterwards, I think the guy behind me was calling, and cold calling the 2-bets cold. And yeah, on the flop, I decided to bet, and yeah, and it got raised. And yeah, this seems to be a tough spot for me. So he cold called. And he's also not raising the full pot. When people do this, often we like to keep you in the pot. So not sure what to do here. It's quite a tough one. We got bottom two and a gut shot, but a weak one too. And a backdoor flush draw. Let's try to figure out what we should have done in a normal 3-bet pot. And take this as bottom line to our analysis. Although the action in this hand was a little different. But yeah, these spots cannot be modeled with the tools we got. Jack 9-6. We don't have this one. So we are already in trouble. That's man, it's so annoying that we only got these few spots. What is close to the one we got? Jack 10-6. Jack 10-6 seems kind of okay, I guess. I think that's the best we got. And yeah, let's see. We also will need to have to change our hand a little bit. Let's make it 10-6. Seven, six, seven, five. So it's like 10-6-7-8 or something. Black filters. So we should check most of the time, and we are allowed to bet if and only if we got a flush draw too. And so okay, and if we checked, let's first be confronted with a pot size bet. 10-6-9-7-8. Oh, that's a card too much. Take away the 9. Okay. If we have no flush draw, we are supposed to call the flop. If we got the flush draw, we are supposed to raise, and we are supposed to play a mixed strategy between raising 50% and raising big. Okay, what happens if we face a smaller bet? Ten, six, seven, eight. Ten, six, seven, eight again needs a flush draw in order to re-raise, and all the other versions will just call. Does it make a difference if we have 7-8 or 9-8? I mean, our gut shot is a bit better, but yeah, it makes no difference. The hands are played the same way, just our equity goes up a bit. Yeah, it's. It will also be hard to analyze this one, I say. If we try to come up with ranges for the guys, I think I 3-bet most likely the McCulloch 86 guy, and yeah, as he was open raising for minimum, and then we had a 3-bet pot. My thoughts in hand were that I need to bet. I'm best off taking it down right now, and yeah, I also was fine and very comfortable to get it in against McCulloch, but I hate when I get raised from Dalaga 18. I'm also, I wonder what I did and how the hand played out, and if I had had the action remembered correctly. Let's try to find the hand. So it's a zoom hand, so I need to go to the fast forward hands, and we have 9-7-6-5. Okay, looks like I chickened out and folded. Yeah, that's exactly what happened. Should we try to build range in Pro Poker Tools, but this always sucks as Pro Poker Tools, if you take like a percentage wise range, this will be taking all the top hands and not the human like range with some speculative stuff as well, like the hand I got. But yeah, let's look into it. So the board is 6 diamond, jack spades, 9 hearts. We got 5 diamonds, 6 hearts, 9 spades, 7 hearts. I think we have to give him quite a good range and a strong one too, because he also has another guy behind who might get it in light. So he has jack 9, he has jack 6, he has all sorts of straight draws. I think there's a very good way to account for them. Oh, you also have the sets. That's very convenient that you can select all this stuff. Can he have 6-9 is the question. I think not, so let's not put that in here. There are no flush draws, but many straight draws. Let's add this one, this one. 8-7-5, what is it? Bottom wrap. Are people going crazy with the bottom wrap? We might. He's also quite loose, so let's add this, let's add this too. Do we need to add this? Yes, we add all this, and we will edit the range now. So jack 9, 6, 8, all the sets. These are the strong straight draws. Not sure if this one is good enough. Let's say this weak one, he also needs a pair in addition to the hand he has. Yeah, that's fair, I guess. Queen 8-5, what is this? This Like two gut shots. So he needs top pair with this one. With this one he needs top pair two, I guess. Needs either top pair or kings, so king or jack. With this one he could also have queens, I guess. People might, some dudes slow play. Not slow play, but cold call queens with, when they are sort of semi-connected. So let's keep it in. They are also not that many combos. Queen 10 is an open ender. What is ace queen jack 5? This is very weak. So let's remove this one. Queen 10 is the not open ender. But he will need some backup in order to go bananas with this. So a jack or a queen. So it is queens. Yeah, I think that's fair. 10-8 is the worst open ender, but with a jack it might be enough for him. So 7-8 is also an open ender, but yeah, that's would be kind of crazy. He goes all in. You would need, yeah, let's remove that one completely. Queen 10 we also had, 10-8 also. 7-8 we had removed that. So yeah, I guess we can remove all the rest from here. Yeah, we have in quiet. Yeah, I think these are sort of reasonable. So let's see how we would do against this range. As you can see, we are only at 34%, and yeah, so we would be allowed to call a pot size raise, but I think there's a bit more than that left. So my fold probably was correct. Yeah, not sure if I'm better off checking, because other than a 6 or a 9, I basically hate every single card, and I potentially would give two people free cards, and I'm also fine to get it in against McCullough, whatever, however his name is, but I have a problem getting it in against Dalaga. Your streams same time with another PLO streamer and at this, not many around. Try another schedule and some live play later in the day and you will grow with small steps. Yeah. Not sure if I want to stream live sessions, because this is distracting me and definitely lowering my V. And I'm not sure if I'm giving away too much if I do live play. I mean, if your opponents see your stream, they can figure out what you are doing in many spots and have a lot more information. And I might be giving more stuff away when I actually think. And yeah, this would be very bad if people would be able to get a very good read on me by seeing all my hole cards. And yeah, I don't make any profit or anything from the stream yet, and yeah, also don't expect to make anything or much later. So not sure if it's worth doing live sessions, but yeah, I definitely enjoy this sort of content. I also there are no other streamer doing this, basically. I mean, Jay Nander sometimes does some analyses, but they are quite basic most of the time, and also he wastes like so much time. I mean, one analysis is like 1 hour or something, and most of the time he's just talking some stuff or having the sim run in the background and is not doing anything. And yeah, it just feels like a huge waste of time. And in comparison, in my stream, you go through many, many hands, and I hope that people also can learn a lot. So yeah, I think that's already the last hand for today. But yeah, to not wrap it up too quick, I can also show you some of the huge hands we won on PLO 1K today. So yeah, before wrapping it up, I show you some of the big hands. By the way, I think this is most likely not a 3-bet. Let's check this out. UTG Open. UTG Open, we are on the button with Ace, King, King, Queen. I'm like very, very sure that it's not an open and not a re-raise, because the UTG range is supposed to be very tight, and yeah, we hate facing a 4-bet. Yeah, as you can see, we are supposed to put in the 3-bet only if, oh, is this actually true? It's a single suited version. This single suited version is not re-raising. So there are there single suited versions which are re-raising? There's a single suited version to the king re-raising. So seems like he is re-raising some king high suits and the double suited versions, but only some. Is this true? No, the double suited versions seem to get re-raised always, and the king high suit is re-raising, not the ace high suit. So intuitively I did it correct. Let's also try to find out what our action is if we face a 4-bet. I guess our action is a fold, but I don't know. Ace, king, king, queen. No. Oh, actually it is. So even the double suited version of our hand is folding. So yeah, some of these hands are used as like, yeah, we are 3-betting for value, but then once we get 4-bet, our hand is not worth continuing with in a GTO world. So yeah, but he's just calling, luckily, and we flop very huge. And yeah, I decided to bet the full pot. And yeah, I'm not sure if that's correct. I did this because I don't block any of the draws, or only the straight draws a bit, a straight draw a bit. And this also looks like someone having aces, yeah, just trying to end the hand right now. Okay, back, call. No, wrong. Ah, okay, just give me a moment to set up the flop sim. King 9-4 is our board. King 9-5 is the only one we got, so we take this one. It's check to us, and we have ace, king, king, queen. And yeah, we should check back if we block the nut flush draw, and we should, what else is checking back? Yeah, we are doing quite some slow plays, as you can see. And if we bet, we should only bet 50% and not the full pot as I did. Anyways, he sticks it in. I happily call. And he has the ace, queen, queen, seven. So yeah, the queens with the nut flush draw, and luckily I hold and win a big pot. Let's see if he is supposed to fold pre-flop. My guess would be yes. Is this really my guess? He could also be supposed to forbid. Let's find out. My guess is fold. My guess is incorrect. If he is double suited, or if he has the ace high flush draw, he should continue. But it's very close if you have only the ace high flush draw and if you are not double suited, as you only lose 0.04 BBs less than in the case of a fold. And to be honest, this hand plays terribly, and we are not a solver who can play perfect balanced ranges, so it might even be correct to fold the single suited version. But the double suited version seems to be a defend. So yeah, my opponent played it good, he just got coolered. And let's go into another hand. I almost felt bad for this Ben Apart guy, because most money I won was from him, and yeah, I also got the best out of him in almost every pot, and he also quit the table after losing like 3k or something. I'm not sure if he's irregular or not, I guess so, but yeah, I don't know. So I bet the turn, making two pair, and yeah, he now surprisingly raises. In my eyes, he's not representing a lot. I mean, he is value hand wise, he's representing queen 10, and that's it. I think most people don't check back flops with a set, maybe with like set of queens with the nut flush draw, but that's it. And I also have a blocker to a set of queens, so I didn't believe him. So I was like, fuck, what's going on at this point? And I was like, what is he representing? What should he have? And I was just like, ah, fuck it. I put in all the money. And yeah, he seemed not to like it, so he just called. And as the river bricks, I mean, it's not a brick, to be honest, not a complete brick, as some straights got there, but the unlikely ones. And yeah, with only these small amount left, I think I'm best off to just shoving myself, hoping to get a hero call from something that is now like, oh fuck, I can't fold getting that good of a price. Then checking to him and only getting more money in case he hit his draw. So I think betting is the best, and yeah, he folds. I think we also got one more big hand against the dude. So yeah, that's also against him. This probably is, yeah, let's see if the solver wants to 3-bet. So we have a cutoff raise. We are the small blind with queen 7-4. We can also check at least our flop line if it's solver approved or not. Queen 7-4 is supposed to call, so that's solver approved. And queen 7 deuce is our flop, so call, fold. Queen 7 deuce was it? Queen 7. We have this one, so close enough, I guess. And we now download it. Queen, yeah, we can keep our hand. Queen, queen 7-4. Queen, queen 7-4. Apply filters. We're not supposed to have this hand ever. So, what's going on? Hey, I think we did everything correct. So why is this hand not in our range anymore? Queen, queen, seven. Ah, it's seven deuce. 7-4 seems to be a re-raise. No, seven deuce is also not in our range. What? What is going on? Hey, I don't understand. Let's just do queen, queen. Apply filters. I don't understand. So let's just redo it and hope that it's working next time. Back download. So let's check our hand again if it's a GTO defend. Queen, queen, seven deuce. So, and why this is not working out? Queen, queen, seven deuce. Apply filters. Aha, so queen, queen, seven deuce. Is a fold even? Double suited? Yes, it is. But we got queen, queen, 7-4. My bad. And queen, queen, 7-4 is a defense. So, what is the problem here? Call fold. Putting the board back in. Queen, queen, 7-3. Download. Queen, queen, 7-4. Apply filters. Sure. What? What? Queen, queen, 7-5. Okay, let's do it with queen, queen, 7-5 instead, as the other one is magically not in the range. And yeah, we should check 100% of the time. And what do? I check. And I am faced with a bet. So I check, he bets, he's supposed to bet 3/4 pot only, but we don't have this option in solver world. We got queen, queen, 7-5. And queen, queen, 7-5 is a mix between calling and raising, but most of the time raising. The combo, we got two backdoor flush draws. So let's add two backdoor flush draws, spades and diamonds. I guess we cannot have spades and diamonds because the queen is in spades, so we diamonds and clubs. Diamond and clubs. And this hand is slow playing a bit more than raising. And yeah, I decided to slow play as I am blocking the board heavily and he most likely has nothing at all. So I thought just calling should be fine and yeah, trapping him, and maybe he thinks that I'm scared money or an idiot or on a weak range when I just call. And yeah, that's why I just called. And yeah, on the turn he bets smallish again, like half pot, even a bit less, and I again choose to just call. I mean, I'm completely crushing the board and he don't want to scam out, and I also want him to bluff the river in case he might be trying to move me off a queen or something, because my hand so far looks very weak. I call a mini flop bet, I call the small turn bet as well only, and yeah, So I guess he might make a move, and on the river he finally bets full pot. And yeah, I race him and he snap folds. I mean, I even wasn't giving away timing tells, or maybe this was a timing tell. I mean, I was not snap re-raising, but I re-raised him. And yeah, he was like, he had no decision at all. He was like, in a blink of an eye, he threw his cards away. So I guess I played it perfectly and he put me on scared money or something and was bluffing. Yeah, I mean, I was also not scared of the pocket deuces. Yeah. Another nice pot from this dude. And yeah, I guess that's it from today for today. I hope you enjoyed these replays from Big Hands too. And yeah, I guess we see each other tomorrow. I can't promise yet, but yeah, most likely I will upload something tomorrow too, or even go live. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to check me out on social media and also on YouTube as well. If you miss any streams, you can always re-watch the content on YouTube. Yeah, again, thanks for watching. Bye bye, until next time.